New for Hypermill 2019.1 is a new cycle, brand new, called Prismatic Fillet Machining. Now, we all know that Tangent Plane came before. This particular box here has some undercut walls, some tilted over fillets here, and not real difficult, but not super simple either. So Tangent Plane, basically pick a tool, barrel tool, strategy, pick some planar surfaces to machine. Give it some general 5-axis parameters and calculate a tool path. This is a new button here. This is a global transparency. We'll basically turn your part transparent. It works pretty much with this same button over here, but this is this is a Hypermill function, and this is purely CAD. Okay, so very automatic. The system goes through and cuts the planar surfaces and is designed to clean the plane. Let a little cleanup cut here. Make sure that it gets to all the edges. Comes in and cleans all those up. Fantastic. But what am I to do with these fillets now? Well, there's a new cycle called Prismatic Fillet Machining. Pick a tool, the same tool in this case, pick a strategy. Here I'm going to pick the surfaces. There's one there, there's one here, there's one there. And this one's too small for that tool to get in, so I'm not going to select it. Okay, in this case, the ISOs on those surfaces, in my estimation, are probably good enough. You do have global orientation as well. I have a scalloped optimized, so I can give it a scallop height and it'll make step overs based on that. I like to production mode because it gives a nice turnaround at the top and bottom. Under 5-axis, we have tip and we have barrel. It depends on what I want to cut with. So when I say tip, we can also use, in addition to barrels, straight bull nose cutters and ball ends. So those would use tip. In this case, I'm using a barrel tool. We can give it the contact point somewhere between 0 and 1. Here we're just going to go halfway, and then I give it a maximum angle to Z that I want it to go. And I calculate. So it's important to watch this console window here because it gives you clues to when something might be going wrong. So it's a cycle that's very automatic, like the tangent plane machining, but it's designed to clean up the corners. Okay, so it did produce a tool path. Let's take a look at what it did. What it's basically doing is in the cycle, we said cut from bottom to up. You have a clockwise or counterclockwise direction, and I can see what it's doing. Here you can see the contact point. I have a transparent tool, and just by highlighting all the surfaces, I just use A on the keyboard. It seems to give me a pronounced representation of a contact point. Another trick I use, if I highlight this barrel tool and you just give it a back and forth there, you can see there's many more triangles now. And so the contact point looks larger. And so we're contacting as we're coming up, then we're rapiding back down and contacting as we're coming up. Okay, that's what I would expect it to do. In this particular fillet, we could use a bigger tool still. In this case, I didn't. Okay. And in case you need to know how to make a tool transparent, if we go into the Hypermill settings and then the document colors, look for the tool. I usually make the tool white and then I add a transparency 37-35%. So then when you do your tool simulation, you get a transparent tool instead of a solid tool. And the transparency allows me to see the contact point, which I think is pretty important when you're doing these kinds of things. Okay. So, easy planes, easy corner fillets. this particular corner fillet here, I chose in this case to use a ball tool. Kind of a big holder and a ball tool of 6 millimeter. Basically pick the fillet, global orientation in this case, give it a scallop height, calculate the tool path. Let's simulate the tool path. It's important to watch to see that check and close and everything's successfully completed. Okay, so as we watch this, the tool kind of increments in there to try to accommodate that sort of oversized holder. It'd be a lot better not to have a holder of that size, something more narrow, of course, but in a pinch it can do it. Okay, this minimum lag angle, it's very important to know what that does. It's a tilt angle off of the walls, a minimum tilt angle. If I tried to set that at 45 to get the tool to be more straight in between these two walls and calculate, okay, so it says maximum possible inclination is 40, which is here. It says it wants more, and then it couldn't finish, ended with an error. In this case, actually by changing giving it a lesser angle to the walls and letting it move around in there more actually helped it to finish. I have a stick out of 26. The minimum would be 22. With bull nose and ball ends, you can use this reduce function just like any other cycle that we have. Unfortunately, with a barrel tool, we don't get that. But in this case, it was able to fit that tool in there with a, in my opinion, a pretty undesirable holder. but still a fairly short tool. Okay, that's one way to get that smaller corner. Here's another function here. A couple things I wanted to show here. We're able to use a bullnose barrel tool. So here it says tip type bullnose. And there's zigzag is the strategy. You got down or up or zigzag. And then the sidestep over, you have clockwise, counterclockwise, which is left to right, right to left, or outside in. Outside in does a nice function where it starts on that side, rotates to this side, and kind of does a collapsing climb cut outside the inside. So another nice function there. Under parameters, I tend to like this production mode quite a bit. It gives you pretty nice rotations here, or at smooth connection moves at the bottom, and does a pretty nice job. So you can also use, in this case, I'm using the barrel of a bullnose barrel. Okay, so let's go over to this corner here. Well, I'm using, in this case, I'm using a barrel tool, but with a big ball end on it. And I'm gonna try under five axis, it'll say barrel here. Strategy, zigzag, up and down, clockwise. Pick a surface. In this case, I'm gonna pick this surface. And if you take a look at the ISO lines here, this surface is pretty, the ISOs are very rotated and the system's just not gonna like it. So, you know, you see this ISO line here and then this was really disjointed and then this one here. The best thing to do here, okay, it says ender with an error. Best thing to do here is just resurface it. So there's a new surface. The ISO lines are much straighter. Okay, let's pick that surface to cut. Same parameters, let's recalculate it. Okay, collision avoidance not possible, finished with an error. So when it got over to here, the holder starts to get into the wall here and there's no way to fit that barrel on that last edge of the tool without without the holder hitting that wall. So that's not gonna work for this particular tool. But what I can do is come over here to five axis, set it to tip. I'm gonna set the minimum lag angle. If I do a right mouse and a help here, okay, and I look at lag angle, minimum lateral inclination. So the keywords here are lateral inclination to the surface to be machined. And by the way, this is our new HTML-based help. So this is also brand new for 2019.1. Okay, so right now the minimum lag angle is 45. And I'm going to calculate it now based on the tip of that barrel tool. Okay, and now it finished. And so basically, it's staying it's not moving a lot side to side because of the large lateral minimum angle I have to maintain. If I changed it to 20, okay, it says it with with that less steep angle, it wants to rock the tool around too much, and then the holder hits this wall over here. Okay, so 45, maximum angle to Z is 80 in this case. By giving it a bigger lateral angle, it'll finish. And then the A is tipped at almost 60. I said it can go as much as 80. So let's put that down at 50, see what happens. So that should tilt the tool up. Okay, so now it's having problems again. It exceeded the maximum Z by 6 degrees. So if I put in 60 here, I'm guessing it'll work. There we go. And then once again, I can see that 59.843 is what it found to work. Okay, so basically, you know, not long stick out lengths and fairly automatic programming to get those prismatic fillets. Let's go to this wall here. We've got tangent plane machining. Okay, we know we can do that fairly easily. In this case, I used a 20 millimeter bullnose, so we can take a tool and just take it to the bottom, cut on the way up, take it to the bottom, cut on the way up. This has a minimum radius of curvature of 14.866, and it's a 20 millimeter bullnose, so it should fit in that corner. Okay, same prismatic fillet function. I can also use a large barrel tool and cut with the barrel in there. So that worked as well. A little more 5-axis motion though, because the orienting a barrel tangent to the tool usually requires readjustment of the tool angle. Or we could just use a large ball tool. Here we go again. This is a pretty large ball, but I'd like to have a little more room on this side here. So let's open up the cycle. It's a 20 millimeter ball under 5-axis. There's this minimum lag angle of 20, which says I have to stay 20 degrees off of this wall. But if I was to increase that to 45 and recalculate it, meaning I have to stay somewhat in between this 90 degree angle here. Okay, so it collision detected. Let's see what that is. But here you can see the tool is staying away from those walls. Okay. We also know that we can machine this way. Tangent machining, path mode, Z level. Pick three surfaces. And calculate. Of course, the barrel radius has to fit in here. So there it goes and does its Z level cutting. And I'm getting some irregular results with my barrel cut here. And the reason is if I look at this ISO and this ISO and this ISO, these are not lining up very good. So what can I do? To get a better result, I can reconstruct those walls. Basically, there's just a straight leg up and down there, a straight leg between the fillets there. Reconstruct those surfaces. Repick those. ISO strategy will work well when the ISOs line up well. Okay, there we go. Much better looking path because of much better looking surfaces. We could also try ISO. Since they line up now. Very similar result. Okay, so that's the new prismatic fillet finishing, and that goes in tandem with the tangent plane machining to make an easy programming with the flat planes and the fillets. New in HyperMill 2019.1.